Okay, so now I'm going and going to next thing, which is very important for Agile, for leading for these days development, which is API testing. So before starting API testing, please explain me what you guys understand from API testing. I'll be explaining APIs, what we are testing, what are the request response, then we will install Postman, and then we will I'll give you a get and post, and we'll give a walkthrough of this Postman. So can anyone explain what is API? What is the use of API?
Using API, we can set, insert, update, like post, put. These are the things. We can change the parameter values using the post and put
values. That is fine. You are right. You are absolutely right. But what my first question is, what?
Okay.
You are doing.
If you want, I can give you an example of Ixigo website. What Ixigo is doing is, it is getting fetching from other servers like Air India, Indigo, Vista, everything. It's fetching the values. How it's fetching? Are they giving the access to their website? No, right? They are giving the get APIs of those, of their applications, their main servers. So it's fetching the APIs, and it's fetching the always, it's changing the prices, everything depends on the main server, what it is doing.
Okay, so what type of API testing you have performed? I mean, which tool you have used?
Actually, we have used this Postman tool. Not right now. In my past organization, I have worked. So I used to get the error codes as well, like 400, 504. There are some values. These everything is maintained in the confluence for which code, what should be coming, and everything.
Okay, so. In a way, you have explained correctly what is API. So basically, these days, what we are doing everything as a service. So we are not purchasing that full thing for our usage. What we are doing, like suppose I am a currency converter, right? My job is to convert currency or to tell you weather of a city. So what I'll do, I'll create an APIs, right? I will sell it to different customers. Suppose I have a weather converters. So suppose you, in your application, wanted to display weather of different countries, currency of different countries. So suppose there is a drop down, you mentioned Japan. So it should display Japan currency and Japan weather. What is the temperature? So these two things, why you write code on your own when there is already created APIs and things are there? So what you will do, you will come to me, you will ask, hey, Prakash, can you send me your APIs? I'll say, I can send, but I'll charge for it. So you will say, what is the charge? So I'll say, what is your need? You will say, my need is every day 100% are hitting. So I'll say, no, 100% is very less. I want to pay you in a monthly basis. So we go and negotiate on those terms, and we decided, okay, for a month usage, I'll ask you $5,000 for currency converters and $4,000 for weather. So such kind of, this is an example of licensing, but I'm saying, so this way we will started interacting and using APIs of different customers. So you came to me, and I sold you weather and currency converter APIs. Now what happens? I exposed you the request and response, get and post APIs of currency and these two things. Basically, I'm sharing you the get, not post. I will not allow you to post. It is only read only. So what you will do, you will call my APIs, enter your values, pass the parameters. That means you will pass the currency, you will pass the country. What I will return? Against the currency, I'll return the value, whichever you wanted to convert into. Suppose you wanted to convert into Japanese dollar, Japanese yen into USD, I'll give it you that value to you. And for weather, if you say Japan weather, I'll revert you 20 degrees Celsius or whatever the value it is, I'll revert that. So what you are doing, you are using my APIs. You are using my API, which I have exposed to you, and you are only just using the JSON thing, right? I'm just exposing, giving it to you into a JSON format. You are getting the JSON and using in your application. So in a way, what happened? You are not writing that code. You are only interacting with an external source, APIs. So another example is banking. So what banking application is being used across what? In mobile app? in thin client, web, suppose there is an ICICI bank whose thick client application is for trading. They have a thick client application as well. Thick client application. Then what next? ATMs. Right. I'm just trying to explain you the communication which is happening on the back of API, how it is moving and where the data is being sent. So guys, can we have a quick call out who all are present at this point of time? Because I see a lot of cache and I mean some random users also. So can you quickly take your name, unmute yourself and name yourself just quickly.
Deepak.
Jatin.
Manoj.
Raghav.
Again. Okay, thanks, Sam. That's fine. So
Prakash, your voice is not audible.
Okay, so is my voice audible now?
Yes.
Yeah, so till which point I was audible? I mean, from how long? Because there are some issues, I feel.
From the point when you asked that who are all available.
Okay, so a couple of 5 minutes I missed, sorry. So basically what I have written here is, in the left, if you can see list of application. For example, I'm having an ICICI bank application, and the application being installed or deployed over mobile app, thin client, thick client, ATMs. And what all these four applications are doing, they are interacting with the backend, and what they are doing the common operation. When I say common operation, that means reading your account statement and transferring money to some other account, doing certain transaction, setting some regular debit feature of paying your bill. So these are all the tasks which are common, which has been done. So for end user, it may be a different application, but at the back end, they are the API which are play major role. So what API is, they're getting the response request from these application and then processing and responding back to that application. So here what at this API layer, JSON or whatever format they have written the APIs is handling the code. And what it is written here, they're just handling the response, which is being requested back by, sent back by the APIs. So what, in a way, what I just wanted to explain is API has eased the way of development. The reusability has increased. So, and at the same time, when reusability has increased, the chances or impact of failure is also increased, because we are using this API, single API across all four application. So if this API fails, all four will fail. So whenever we plan for API testing inside your project, so whoever is involved at the project planning level of test planning or test design at the project level, they must be aware that if your project contain APIs, then you start testing from API, then the database, then APIs, then the functional testing, then system, and then integration. Right? So this flow is very important to understand, because API completes your complete application. Like, complete system will be ready when your APIs are fully ready, or these are not having any issues. So to test this API, there are several tools in market. Like, if you see, there is a tool, Rest Assured, or I would say a jar file, Rest Assured, which you can use inside Selenium, where what you can do, you can simply set and get and post the values which are there. Right? So this is one thing which you can do. And there, the second tool is SOAP UI, which is a very common these days. So if you guys are aware, Cucumber is being purchased by SOAP UI. How many of you are aware of this? So Cucumber is officially have taken over that Cucumber. So all the Cucumber development, Cucumber things which you are seeing independent these days, coming slowly in market in future, SOAP UI will bring features which are, or which will, Cucumber will incorporate in its functionalities. So a lot of API testing which we will see in future using Cucumber. Currently we do not see, but in future we will have. So SOAP UI now owns Cucumber. So this is the API understanding which I wanted to develop. So in a way, API eases out the work of for developers.
So APIs are of two types, SOAP and REST API.
Right.
What I understand.
Yeah. So basically, these are the two SOAP APIs which we have, the RESTful services and the SOAP services. So if I ask, I'm going to tell you, like, the Selenium, in Selenium, you can use the REST Assured, which automates the REST services only, RESTful services. And I talk about the SOAP UI, SOAP UI is a tool which has capability of automating every kind of APIs which we have, SOAP and RESTful. And if any customized microservices there, then also we can do it using the SOAP UI tool. Okay, so reading out the second para, API testing is now considered critical for automation testing, because API is now served as a primary interface to application logic, because GUI tests are difficult to maintain with the short release cycle and frequent changes commonly used with agile software development and DevOps. This is a very important para for agile testers. So as we have discussing yesterday, that Facebook, Amazon, Google, they have huge API list, or they majorly place with the microservices, with the APIs. They don't write long development codes. They write middleware logic, a lot of middleware logic, so that the end testing is very easy. So what they do a lot of API testing. That is why their release cycle is very short, and number of releases or number of the integration tests in the APIs are frequent or huge. Somewhat around hundreds of tests in a day for that particular release, which are happening at Amazon and other big companies. So, and very less engineers they have. The manpower which they are using inside the testing is very less. So these are the top companies which are using QA very efficiently. So that is why whenever you go this time in market and search for a job, if you are good in API testing, if you are a good API tester, there are many chances that you will get more opportunities. Even though at par with automation and sometimes more than automation, if you are very good in writing API tests and automating APIs, then more opportunities are there for you. Okay, so what I'm doing, I'm moving it to a next slide, which is about